Kenyon ISD is making sure their district is prepared during emergencies, what students and staff can expect in the classroom today. Plus, two Lubbock companies are asking for money from Rigger Dykes. Details on their alleged rent issues coming up.
And we are looking at the hot weather for August to continue on into this coming weekend. We'll take a look at that weekend forecast coming up.
Live from your local news leader, KAMR Local 4's Today in Amarillo in high definition starts now.
Good Friday morning. It's August 24th. I'm Angelina Perez. Thanks for waking up to Today in Amarillo. We'll have more on those stories coming up in just a bit. But first, let's look at your weather with meteorologist Chris Martin. Good morning, Chris.
Good morning, Angelina. Good morning, folks. Happy Friday to you. We're looking at a breezy start to the day and temperatures quite a bit warmer than we've seen most of this week. Let's take it over to our downtown tower camera. The sky above us, partly cloudy at the moment. Our temperature's at 75 degrees here in Amarillo. Winds from the southwest at 20 miles per hour, so a bit on the brisk side. We're only down to about 78 at the Boulevard and 75 at Sonsi and I-40 for the day ahead. Thankfully, the winds will back off in the afternoon time. We'll see the chance for rain returning. A few hit and miss thunderstorms as we go into your Friday afternoon with a high of 97 here in town. We'll see how long this latest heat wave lasts in just a few minutes. Right now, we'll send it back over to Angelina.
Thank you, Chris. Two people are in jail and another is arrested in Amarillo after two stolen trucks and a trailer were recovered in Hansford County. Spearman police say Weston Shipley and Duane McQuery were arrested after the Auto Task Force confirmed with the department the vehicles were stolen from Amarillo. Police say Justin Thomas Hutton was arrested by Amarillo law enforcement last night. According to a release from the Spearman police chief, Lance Swan, an officer spotted a truck and trailer at a gas station air pump at about 2 a.m. on Wednesday. While the officer was investigating, he says the truck drove off towards Perryton. In Ochiltree County, Sheriff's deputy found the trucks and the trailer on a county road. Two real estate companies in Lubbock filed a motion in federal bankruptcy court yesterday, saying essentially Rigger Dykes needs to pay its rent or get off their property. 82nd Street Investments and Lubbock Windmill Real Estate say the dealership leases two properties from them in Lubbock and claims they are behind on their rent. They are asking for past due rent plus August rent. Documents show the rent at the location runs at $20,000 and $35,000 respectively per month. A hearing is set for September 19th to address this motion. Another document filed today is asking a judge to let Rigger Dykes use cash collateral to pay $6,500 in rent for a Plainview property. Today, Kenyon students and teachers are practicing what to do in case of an emergency. It's the district's annual safety day. Classes across the district will be conducting a different emergency drills like fire drills, lockdowns, and tornado drills. All week, teachers and staff have been conducting an educational safety program to prepare for those drills. During the drills, each campus will look to assure predictable response times, identify problems and weaknesses in the emergency plans. Some young people recovering from illnesses will get special visitors today when the first couple shows up to a children's hospital in Ohio. We are your local election headquarters. President Trump and First Lady Melania Trump will visit Nationwide Children's Hospital in Columbus. The first couple will be in the state capitol for GOP fundraisers. The president will headline the 2018 Ohio Republican Party state dinner. He will also campaign for U.S. Representative Jim Renacci. Who is seeking to unseat Democratic U.S. Senator Sherrod Brown in November. For related headlines, head over to myhighplains.com. Three people were injured when a car flew across a median and hit a school bus in Mississippi yesterday morning, and it was all caught on tape. Take a look at this. According to police in Pearl, the Camaro was driving recklessly on an off-ramp and slid into a school bus and another car, causing the Camaro to flip. No children were on the school bus, but the driver was taken to the hospital by ambulance. A mother and her child in a separate car were also taken to the hospital. According to a witness, the driver of the Camaro, 24-year-old Eric Payton, was able to crawl out of the car and check on the other cars he hit. Payton was arrested for not having insurance. A local organization is trying to make a more inclusive and safe play space for area children. That's in today's Heart of the High Plains. Slam Zone Kids Gym is on a mission to provide a safe indoor play area for children with sensory processing challenges. Construction on their facilities has just started, and while a lot of the work being done is through volunteers. They are still trying to raise money for play equipment. Today, they are hosting their first ever golf tournament at Ross Rogers Golf Club, with 100% of the proceeds going towards construction and equipment. All of the equipment within the space will be specifically designed to help tackle physical and mental obstacles faced in typical play spaces.